everyone, your employer services team wanted to take a few minutes just to say hello. We miss being in the field with you and with your employees, and we were really disappointed this year not to be able to host the Benefits at Work conference, but we at PIBA felt that it was best for everyone's health and safety to cancel the conference. So I'll let everybody say hey, but only if they promise to mention something PIBA related that's on their mind. So let's see what they got.
Hi everyone, I'm Kimberly. Welcome to my backyard. We were very disappointed when the BAW had to be canceled this year. No BAW means no touch points with our vendors. And so I'm here to share some vendor news with you and tell you why and how you can keep in touch with them this year. The Standard and Express Scripts have both been awarded contracts with PIBA again. So the disability and prescription drug benefit vendors remain the same. Get to know our vendors. They provide you and your employees with the best benefits available. MetLife for life insurance, Standard for disability benefits, iMed is your vision plan, Blue Cross Blue Shield is our health and dental vendor, Express Scripts is our prescription drug benefit vendor, and ASI Flex has the Money Plus accounts. If you have questions, they have answers. A contact list of these vendors is available on our website at www.piba.sc.gov, search Health Hub, and you'll find the list there. I hope to see you face-to-face real soon. Let us know how we can help. Take care.
PIBA is required to select 4 vendors to provide third-party record-keeping administration for the state optional retirement program. The 4 vendors that have been selected for the contract period beginning on January 1st, 2021 are MassMutual, TIAA, Valic, and Voya. Please note that Voya will be replacing MetLife as the 4th vendor. Additional information on the transition will be forthcoming in the near future, so be on the lookout for it.
PIBA Update is our employer newsletter and is the best way to stay up to date with news from PIBA. PIBA Update is emailed weekly to employers that are listed as contacts in EES and EBS. If you are not receiving PIBA updates, then you will need to have your contact information updated in EES and EBS. To update your contact information in EBS, have your authorizing agent log in and update the communications contact list. For EES, anyone who has access can add to the list.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. This is Paul Graham with Field Services. And I wanted to say a few words to you all about our new website. The communications department has done a fantastic job of updating and upgrading our website. If you haven't got a chance to go by and look at it, I sure hope you do. Everything that you need is there. It's laid out a little bit differently. So, you know, just like going to a new grocery store, you have to find where the essentials are. And perhaps you want to bookmark those, but we think that you'll be very pleased with everything that they've done. And so browse around, check it out, find out where stuff is. And if you have any problems, you know how to get us.
Hey, y'all. In case you don't recognize me, I'm Karen Rall. Hoping you're well and gearing up for the enrollment. We certainly miss not having the conference and not being able to be in the field with you and your employees, but we're committed to giving you the information that you need to get started for enrollment. Specifically, I'd like to throw out a few reminders for our optional employers. First, I want to remind you about experience rating and adding the load factors to your health premiums, both for the employee and for the employer sides. Now's the time for you to find the notification letter mailed to you or maybe your financial director in March of 2020. This letter is very important because it gives you the load factor for your claims and your experience history and the percentage you will add to the health premiums for your group for the plan year 2021. If you can't find the letter, you can call our customer service department and they can pull it from our imaging file and send it to you. Secondly, let's talk about our newsletter. Remember, our newsletter lists monthly premiums for our state agencies, our public school districts, and our higher ed entities. Because you, our optional employers, are experience rated, your premiums may be different than those appearing in our newsletter. When you apply the load factor notification letter we mailed back in March, we recommend that you calculate your rates in advance and before handing out that newsletter to your employees. Our communications department, they're currently working on an article that will have a link for a fillable monthly premium worksheet that will make it easier for you to communicate your group's premiums to your employees. You can include health premiums impacted by the load factor or any health, dental, and vision premium subsidies by you, the employer, on this worksheet. PIBA is going to announce our final health premiums for the 2021 plan year by October 1st. And the EBS premium reports will be published as soon as they're right thereafter, I think. Last reminder, remember you can't pass along any portion of the required minimum employer contribution to an employee, but you can always elect to subsidize a portion or all of your employees' premiums. Well, that's it for me. Hope you had a chuckle at my expense. Stay safe, stay healthy, and we hope to see you very, very soon.
Hi, my name is Michelle, and I am from PIBA's Field Services team. I was so disappointed when this year's BAW conference was canceled and we could not see each other face to face. PIBA's primary concern is the safety of all during these continuing uncertain times. If you are unaware, the insurance summary and the insurance benefits guide will not be printed this year. However, all of the open enrollment resources you will need to have a successful open enrollment this year will be available on PIBA's website. It is very important that you take the time to locate and familiarize yourselves with the available resources. Also, please continue to review PIBA's weekly updates. They are designed to keep you informed on pertinent information and any new updates or upcoming changes. Continue to practice safe distancing and wear your mask. Have a great day. Be safe.
Hello, everyone. It's Tim of PIBA's Field Services Department. Hate that we can't be within your presence at this time, but we shall persevere. Encourage your employees to find their own way to good health and retirement planning using PIBA's many available online resources. Member access may be used to update beneficiaries, generate annuity estimates, and even apply for retirement. My Benefits is useful for more than just open enrollment. Subscribers can also verify their coverage or make coverage changes due to special eligibility situations and update beneficiaries. You can certainly be the wind inside their sails, but encourage your employees to be the captains of their own ships. No matter where we find ourselves today or tomorrow, be it near or far, together or apart, rest assured that PIBA is constantly improving on serving the workers and people of South Carolina as they are. Wherever they are, employee, employer, retiree, it doesn't really matter who you are.
Thank y'all, that's a lot of great information, and I'm really pleased to see that you managed to get out of your PJs and look presentable. You may have noticed that we are missing one of our teammates, Diane Conti. She made the decision to retire earlier this year, and we're gonna miss everything that she brought to the table. We're all experiencing daily changes in our work environments and our home environments. And we really hate that we're not going to be able to see you at the BAW conference this year. But check out the webpage, a lot of great information on there. And as always, we're here to help, so don't hesitate to reach out to us. Stay safe and stay well.
You can get anywhere from here. Or here. Even here.